Hey everybody, welcome to Citizens Bank Park. Welcome to Phillies Baseball. And tonight, the Video Game Network presents the Baltimore Orioles and the Philadelphia Phillies. And G here with you for Phillies Baseball on the Video Game Network. Phillies trying to avenge a 9-4 loss against the Orioles. And as they get ready to take the field for the second half of the four-game series. First half was a home-and-home. The Phillies tomorrow split. And they're back here at Citizens Bank Park. Cliff Lee against Chris Tillman on the mound for the Orioles. They won't use a designated hitter in a National League ballpark, so Chris Tillman will bat. And with Hardy, Jones, and Davis off the top, they'll face Cliff Lee, who was 4-5 with a 4.11 ERA, 18 walks, 24 strikeouts. So the strikeouts have not been coming as of late. Ready to start, and Steve Pierce will lead it off, batting at 245.
Right fielder, Steve Pierce.
And the first pitch is inside for a ball, one ball and no strikes.
First pitch, 7-06.
Fly ball hit the left field on the second pitch of the game, and that is a home run for Steve Pierce. So the Orioles jump out in front, 1-0 here in the first inning. A leadoff home run for Steve Pierce. Well, this was boom, right down the heart of the plate. And Pierce just whacked it. No doubt about it. That's his seventh. Here's J.J. Hardy batting at 251 with five home runs.
J.J. Hardy.
One strike. One ball and one strike.
1-1.
Two balls, one
strike.
Here we go now, Phil.
Yeah.
2-2 to count. Hit foul. Cliff Lee giving up a home run early. He's had his problems.
That ball's foul.
And he said it would be his final year. And he might just hang it up after this season. That's a base hit in the center field. So Hardy at first after the home run by Pierce.
Batting third, center fielder number 10, Adam Jones.
Yeah, that one just ran the heart of the plate. Here's Adam Jones.
Oh, and one.
One strike to Jones. Jones is batting at 251. That one is foul. Jones in the left field, that's a base hit. So Jones is aboard. Hardy at second.
Batting fourth, first baseman number 19, Chris Davis.
Here is Chris Davis. Well, Lee in some trouble after giving up the home run. Now finds himself second, first and second. Nobody out. Davis 298. He has 13 home runs this season.
Ball. 1-0.
One ball and no strikes. Count.
Ball out.
2-1. Dumb and Young waits on deck.
Yeah.
Now the count is full. Orioles lead 1-0. The Phillies have yet to record an out. And he walks Davis to load the bases. So Lee in some trouble.
Delman Young.
And they'll bring up Delman Young. Batting at 294, 8 home runs.
Get the lead runner already.
Cliff Lee can use a strikeout here. Ripped it hard, but it's foul. He's hacking hard at it. Another foul, no balls and two strikes. Oh, that ball's hammering in a gap, and that's going to go all the way to the wall. Hardy scores. Here comes Adam Jones. He'll score. Davis at third, Young at second, and the Orioles lead it 3-0. Still nobody out here in the first inning. And here's Ryan Flattery. Batting at 217.
Deep wins at anything.
And this is picked up where they what they did last night. One ball and no strikes. Foul. One and two to count. Phillies desperately need it out here. Second and third, nobody out. Bounced up there. Throw on a third, not in time. And the count is full. Caleb Joseph waits on deck for the Orioles. And he walked Flattery. And that'll reload the bases.
Batting seven, the catcher number 36, Caleb Joseph.
So Caleb Joseph will be the batter. Batting at 204. Three home runs. Bases are loaded. The seventh player to come to the plate here. They still have yet to record an out. That is a ball. One ball and no strikes. Lee not looking sharp here in the first inning. Has not recorded an out. Two or nothing. Hit foul, two balls and one strike. Got that over, two and two. He got no room to put Joseph on here. That is foul. If the Orioles don't ground into a double play this inning, they will bat around. Call third strike. Joseph is out on strikes. It's the first out here in the first. No balls and one strike. Jonathan Shoup batting at 233. One and one. Lee with 35 pitches this inning. And a 3-0 first inning lead. And he's only lucky to be giving up three runs because it could be worse. Two balls and one strike. You can use a double play here. Got that over, two and two. So Lee right now can see his way out of this with just giving up three runs. But he's even two and two to shoot. And now the count is full and Chris Tillman waits on deck.
Come on, let's settle down.
So he needs a strikeout here. And he walks shoot to force in the Orioles fourth run as Davis crosses the plate. Baltimore leads it 4-0 here in the first inning.
Chris Tillman.
And it'll bring up Chris Tillman. Tillman has not batted this season because they use a DH in the American League. The Orioles have batted around. That is a strike. Strikes, 17 balls. Chris Tillman. Up the bat for the Orioles. And he fouls it, so Lee is ahead. No balls and two strikes. So here's the guy that started it off. Here's Steve Pierce. He homered just a while ago, and now he's back up to bat, and he takes a strike. No balls and one strike.
Stop him in the track. Come on, Phillies.
Did he go? One and one. Pierce popped him up. Should be out of the inning. But it's going to go. Did he catch it? Yes, he did. So Lee gets out of the inning, giving up four runs. They leave him loaded. It could have been worse. We go to the bottom of the first. Orioles four, Phillies coming to bat. And Ryan Sandberg, here's his starting lineup. They'll go with Robert, Utley, Jordan Franco, Beltre, Perez, Ruff, Dominic Brown, and Cliff Lee. And here you see the Orioles defensively. There's Ben Rivera batting at 277. He leads the Phillies with 14 stolen bases this season. And right now, the Phillies have to mount a little comeback here. One strike to Rivera. He's got that slow windup. 0-2. One ball and two strikes. Bounced up there, two balls and two strikes. Billy is just 2.5 games back of the first place Florida Marlins. Rivera, base hit to left field. So Rivera is the leadoff base runner for the Phillies.
Second.
They'll bring up Chase Utley. Rivera extends his hitting streak to 7 games. Utley batting at 297. One ball and no strikes. Utley fouls it, 1-1. Utley is a double play ball. So two quick outs for Tillman here in the bottom of the first. And it will bring up Brandon Jordan. On a nice play. And double plays have killed the Phillies this season. Either they have an above 500 record. Brandon Jordan batting at 309. He's got 32 RBIs and 7 home runs. One strike to Jordan. Two balls and one strike. Three and one. Franco waits on deck. Three, Throwing the fouls, it is a full count. Showing his sky, this one in the left field is pretty well hit, but it's... Oh, he misplayed the ball! Oh, man, the ball was misplayed. Jordan will end up at third. He's going to try for it inside the park. Home ball, but he's going to be gunned down at home plate. Oh, Jordan runs the try for it inside the park. Home run. And gunned down at the plate. Delman Young misplayed the ball. Oh, they would have scored it an error.
Leading off for Baltimore.
So it would have been an error, not an inside the park corner. It doesn't matter. Jordan is thrown out. And here's Hardy, and he takes a strike. Fouled out off the glove is 0-2. And that's a base hit in the right field. Another leadoff hit for the Orioles.
Now batting number 10, center fielder Adam Jones.
Cliff Lee, one inning, 48 pitches, two strikeouts, three walks, five hits. It's Adam Jones who singled and scored in the first inning. Goal. This is base hit to left field. Oh, they're doing a lot of first pitch swinging here. And the Orioles have their first two men on base, nobody out. And here's Chris Davis. Well, I don't know where he's angling the pitches at, but they're very hittable. And the Phillies are going to get some bullpen activity up. Here's Chris Davis. Aaron Herring is up in the bullpen. It's one ball and no strikes. And this crowd in a state of shock right now. See Cliff Lee struggling like this. Fouls it off. One ball and one strike. Two and one to count. Low, 3-1, Dumb and Young waits on deck. Ball four. Bases are loaded, nobody out. And you can see the end is going to be near for Cliff Lee. And Ryan Sandberg says that's enough. So you'll see Cliff Lee's line for right now. Four runs right now. He is responsible for all three runners on base. The bases are loaded, nobody out. Aaron Herring will come into the game.
Your attention, please.
And Lee will take that long walk to the dugout. Herring, 14 games, 3-6 with a 6.79 ERA, 24 walks, 41 strikeouts, and 58 in the third inning. A face Dumb and Young double, so this could be a bullpen game for the Phillies, and you didn't want that. That is a strike. Phillies bullpen has been worked mainly the whole season. And his foul is 0-2. Bases loaded, nobody out.
Well, yeah, you're good stuff, Aaron.
That is caught, and a run's going to score. A runner moves up to third, and the Orioles lead it 5-0. So Dumb and Young, his third RBI of the game.
Brian Flaherty.
They'll bring up Brian Flaherty. walked his first time up. 5-0 Orioles. He fouls it. Another foul, no balls and two strikes.
Earn your paycheck to turn the dude. Sweet ball.
So one ball and two strikes.
1-2. Two.
2-2 to count. Bounced up there. Ball gets away. They're going to try to score. Orioles get another run. Adam Jones comes in to score. A wild pitch. Cost the Phillies. So Lee will be charged with another run. So his line is finished, giving up 6 runs in the game. Orioles lead it 6-0 here in the second inning. And Flattery hits this one to Utley, fires over the first for the out. Young moves up to third.
The catcher, number 36.
And I'll bring up Caleb Joseph, who struck out in the first. One strike for Joseph. Right down the heart of the plate.
Hey.
Ball and two strikes.
Two balls, two,
two and two. Joseph strikes out for the second time. That'll end the top of the second. The Orioles tack on 2 more runs. And we go to the bottom of the second. It's 6-0 Orioles. Here's Mikel Franco. He's batting at 284. Phillies need to get something going here. Franco fouls in, no balls and one strike. Franco is going to split the gap in right center. Franco leads off the second with a double. Nice hit by Franco. Adrian Beltre will step to the plate. Beltre is 5-for-33 in his last 8. He's batting at 261. The ball and no strikes.
One.
Two balls and one strike. Beltre hits this to third, and he is out. Franco will have to hold it at second. You got to knock in to take the opportunity. You're going to hit the ball. Try to get it in the center or right field. You got to knock in runs at this point. The Phillies have had their troubles knocking in runs. It's Salvador Perez. He leads the National League with 44 RBIs. One ball and no strikes. Strikes. Darren Ruff waits on deck. Walked him on four. I bring up Darren Ruff. He's batting at 347. But you don't want him to ground into a double play here. That will be a killer. One strike to Ruff. Lights are coming on here at Citizens Bank Park. Phillies trying to get something going here. Down 6-0 here in a second. Lean on that one, 0-2. Ruff strikes out, is two down here in the second inning. They'll bring up Dominic Brown, batting at 228. And strike to Brown. Phillies have two on, two out. Fouls in his 0-2. Another foul. Still no balls and two strikes. Side 1-2. Balls and two strikes. And you got the pitcher coming up. Brown staying alive, trying to do what he can. Count. Aaron Harang waits on deck. You got a decision to make if you're Ryan Sandberg. Do you keep Harang in the game if Brown walks, or do you put a pinch hitter in? It's early in the game. Brown over the second base. It doesn't matter at this point. Phillies lead two, but they can't capitalize on the leadoff double by Franco to the third. is Jonathan Stoop.
Leading off for Baltimore.
He got an RBI with a walk.
Jonathan Scope.
And there's one ball and no strikes.
1-0.
Popped them up over the rough. And the rough makes the play. It is one out. Phillies with the highest team ERA in baseball behind the Rockies. Here's Chris Tillman. Tillman hits this to deep left field. That ball's pretty well hit, but Dominic Brown puts it away. That ball was hit hard, and Tillman almost had himself a home run. And we bring up Steve Pierce. Pierce homered in the first. So this could be a quick inning for Harang. One ball and no strikes. Strike. 2-0. Three balls and no strikes. Three and one. Another foul, three balls and two strikes. Got him. That'll tie the Orioles there in the third. They go in order. Orioles still lead 6-0. There's Aaron Harang. He's batting at 118. He will bat here. Ball and no strikes.
Here.
1-1. Two balls and one strike. Fouls it, two balls and two strikes. Got him. Fire over the first for the out. One down here in the third inning. It'll bring up Ben Rivera. Rivera's single, double. Singled his first time up. One ball and no strikes.
Yeehaw!
And one. Balls and one strike to Rivera. Fouls it 2-2. Rivera hits this to shortstop. And he is out. There's two outs. There's Chase Utley. He's 0-1. Phillies having opportunities, but they just can't cash in here. And six runs they trail by, and that is a huge gap. But they really have to get it going. Two balls and no strikes to Utley. Utley pops it up. And we caught. We got to retire the Phillies here in the third. We go to the fourth. Matt Bastergian will have the call. It's 6-0 Orioles.
He's come in and really put his stamp on this game. Throwing a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Now the pitch. And Jones takes this one for a ball, 1-1. Here comes the 1-1. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Here comes a 1-2. Good pitch there on 1-2 as this is pulled down to third. On to first, and Harang looks sharp thus far in the inning. There are two gone.
First baseman number 19, Chris Davis.
Chris Davis will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Here's the first offering. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
You got to make sure if you come inside, you come way inside. You leave it out a bit, he's liable to hit that thing in the second deck.
Six runs, six hits, one error thus far for Baltimore. And this one's on the inside corner, 1-1.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing it.
The 1-1 home. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Now a ball lined towards center field. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right on that one.
Stepping in now, Delmon Young. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. A runner on first with two away. From the stretch. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1.
Yeah.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Here comes the 1-2. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Now another 1-2. And a swing and a miss is all he can do is reach out in vain for that one, and the side is retired. Orioles leave one. They lead it 6-0. Brandon Jordan. Jordan will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Now here's the first pitch. Knuckle curve down below the knees, 1-0. The 1-0. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. Throw to first by Hardy for out number one.
Now batting, shortstop,
Michael Franco will stand in here. He doubled his first time around. First pitch on the way. Now here's a swing, and he's got the ground ball pitch working this inning. This one's over to first base. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Boy, and he's come out with a plan against these hitters, and he's executed that plan to perfection here early on. That's seven in a row now he's sent down.
Adrian Beltre will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Go, Adrian!
Now here's the first pitch. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
Here's the pitch. Good swing there, but this is fouled off to the right side. Now the 0-2 to Beltre.
Here we go.
Lifted down the line in right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. Now here it comes. And this is hit sharply on the ground toward the hole. Well into the outfield turf as he makes the stop. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Phillies down in order. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Ryan Flaherty will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Third baseman number three, Ryan Flaherty.
Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And here's the first pitch. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Pitch on the way. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. The right-hander deals on 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Yeah, he essentially tripled up there. That means he threw the same pitch 1, 2, 3 times in a row. You don't see that very often, but it's going to work out for him as he gets the strikeout.
Into the box now, Caleb Joseph, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location, right on the knees.
Ah, not the greatest at-bat thus far, as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
And this is part of the reason why he's staring a hat trick right in the face. He just hasn't been able to recognize these pitches that are well out of the zone.
Now here's the pitch. Strike three called, and that is back-to-back punch-outs here in the inning. Three in a row total, and there are two away.
Ouch.
That's a rough night at the ballpark here. Third strikeout. One thing you can't do, though,
You can't go into that dugout hanging your head. You got to think, hey, it's over. I'll get another shot to redeem myself. Whether that's tonight or sometime in the future, that's the attitude you have to have.
Here's Jonathan Scope now. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. One oh pitch now. Swing and a liner. Foul. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
Nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
Here's the 1-2. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for the Orioles, but they're on top by a count of 6-0. Salvador Perez will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
First pitch coming. And a ball, 1-0.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch, something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
And it's a called strike to even the count at one. And now a pitch on the way. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Here's Tillman on 2-1. In the air to right center. And there to put this one away is Jones, and that's out number one.
And with the big lead, he can afford to take a few chances with that fastball. And here, this one works out for him because this is nothing more than an easy fly ball.
In now, Darren Ruff. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing in one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of. Let's go, Billy.
Now the pitch. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Now the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Here's another 0-2. Off-speed pitch, and there is strike three called. And boy, that zone just got a bit larger, two away.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Here's the left-handed hitting Dominic Brown. As he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark. Well, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
Hit hard to short. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They still find themselves down 6-0. Justin DeFreitas will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Chris Tillman will stand in now, and given the big cushion he has to work with on the other side of the scorecard, he'll go ahead and hit for himself here in inning number six. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0.
Oh, that's wrong. That's so wrong.
And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
Yeah, there's a good one right there. Right over the top. Just fire that thing in there.
Let's go, 1-1 on the way. Grounded foul off to the right side. Now the 1-2, and he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. Steve Pierce will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. Here's the first offering. Righty against righty, as this is taken for a ball. It's 1-0.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Hit on the ground to shortstop. Throw gets him, two down.
The batter, number two, shortstop, J.J. Hardy.
J.J. Hardy will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. First pitch to him. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Here it comes. Oh, got him to swing on top of that one as this ball's dribbled out in front of the mound. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. The O's lead this thing 6-0. Xavier Paul is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Too low, 1-0. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
Now a ball hit foul off to the right side, and that just about got the first base coach. Ready now on 1-1. Now a swing, and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate, and he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
Ben Revere will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Here's the first pitch to him. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. Now here's the pitch. The 0-1 is swung on and bounced to the shortstop, Hardy. On to Davis at first, and there are two away.
Boy, his guy's got him the lead back in the very first inning, and he hasn't looked back since. He's had everything go his way so far, and this inning's turning out to be no exception.
Chase Utley will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. First offering on the way. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes. Here's the 1-0. Upstairs with it yet again. It's 2-0 now.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
High and away, not close. 3-0.
I think at this point, a two-out walk isn't the worst thing in the world. You'd like to avoid it if you can, but this can be a dangerous spot if you just groove one.
And he'll just float a change in here now for a strike.
Not turned loose there. I thought that he might be swinging with two away, but apparently not.
Now the 3-1 pitch. Well hit. Deep down the right field line. But this will land foul, shy of the wall. And the pitch. And here's a swing, and another chance out there is short. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. We'll see Adam Jones when we come back. It's the Orioles 6 and the Phillies nothing.
He fouls it. That's foul. Hardy strikes out. Take a look at what Lee did. He pitched only in and gave up 6 runs on 6 hits. Struck out 2, walked 4. You see Tillman's numbers, no runs. 3 hits, 1 walk, and 4 strikeouts. He's still going. Here's Adam Jones. He's 2-for-3. So Lee. Charged with giving up the 6 of the 7 runs. It's just not a good outing for Lee. He couldn't even get out the gate. Two balls and no strikes.
Pick.
2-1. Balls and one strike. Chris Davis waits on deck. That is hit in the left field. Play by Brown. They're going to strong throw by Brown. Tillman stops at third. The bases will be loaded. There's Chris Davis. Jake Diekman will come into the game 3-0 at a 1.02 ERA, 35 innings, 8 walks, 36 strikeouts. So face Davis here with the bases loaded and one out.
Turn two now, let's go.
One ball and no strikes.
One ball, no strikes.
Tomorrow will be a day game.
Two and one.
Two balls, one strike.
Two balls and one strike. Ooh, nice pitch. 2-2. Davis staying alive here. And just foul. Davis, Delman Young waits on deck. The walks have hurt the Phillies in this game. And another foul, the count is still full. And he walks Davis to force him a run. Tillman will come around and score. The Orioles lead it 8-0 here in the eighth inning. Just not the Phillies' night. Orioles picked up where they left off last night. Here's Delman Young. He's 1-for-3. He doubled and has already 3 RBIs. A chance for him to have a breakout game here. Fly ball, right field, Jordan going back, and he makes the catch up against the Fitz. But Young will get his 4th RBI, and it's 9-0 Orioles. Young almost hit it out of the park, but Jordan right in front of the fence makes the catch. And Ryan Flattery will bat. Oh, that one's hit, and that's going to drop for a base hit. Another run will come in, and the Orioles lead it 10-0. And the crowd, you can hear the crowd booing as everything has gone south for the Phillies, as they have given up 19 unanswered runs to the Orioles dating back to last night in the eighth inning. Jerome Williams will come in to pitch. 19 unanswered. And here's Caleb Joseph. A strike to Joseph. Right now they're just hoping that this game will end. In a center field, Ben Revere puts it away, and that'll retire the Orioles, but they get 3 more runs in the inning, and they leave 2 as we go to the bottom of the 8th. All Baltimore here in Citizens Bank Park. Here's Dan Ruff. He is 0-for-2. He has struck out twice. Tillman's still in the game. He's thrown 91 pitches. Yeah, there's 1 ball and no strikes. Two and zero. Balls and no strikes. Dominic Brown waits on deck. Got that over. 95 pitches for Tillman. It's 3 balls and 1 strike.
Come on now, Philly.
Chop foul, the count is full. Ruff hits this one, the shortstop, and he is thrown out. One down there in the bottom of the eighth. And here is Dominic Brown, who was 0-2. A ball and no strikes. Brown has had his struggles at the plate as of late. He does have 9 home runs, but he's been struggling at the plate. Three and O. Got that over. 101 pitches for Tillman. Strike two. Ruff Brown. And it will bring up Ryan Howard. Howard will pinch hit for Jerome Williams. Howard batting at 167. Come on. 0-2 now to Howard. Bear waiting on deck.
Give him the green light.
Howard slugged it a long way, but it's fouled. Howard, high first base, and it's two outs.
The center fielder, number two.
I'll bring up Ben Rivera, who's 1-for-3. It's a strike. 68 strikes, 40 balls. One ball and two strikes.
One ball
and two strikes.
Here we go.
112th pitch coming up here for Tillman.
Nope.
And one nearly hit him.
2-2's the count.
Count. Chase Utley waits on deck. Marks Rivera. So Utley will bat. Utley is 0-for-3, grounded out in the sixth. Bradley fouls it. No balls and one strike.
Get it out of here.
Utley, a base hit in the right field. And Dominic Brown on his way home, and the Phillies get their first run of the game. It's now 10-1 here in the bottom of the eighth. There's Brandon Jordan. He is 0-3. Orioles don't have anybody up in the bullpen.
Ball,
outside, one ball and no strikes. Two and oh. Balls and one strike. Some of the crowd has left Citizens Bank Park. Knowing what the score is. Jordan, oh, base hit. Another run comes in. The ball is bobbled. Jordan has an RBI, and it's 10-2 now. We'll give Jordan an RBI to bring up Mikel Franco. 120 pitches for Tillman now. And he is still in the game. Mikel Franco up the bat. It bounced up there, one ball and no strikes. Phillies with two runs here in the bottom of the eighth. Up there, two balls and no strikes. Two and one.
Come on, Philly.
Nope. That'll end the eighth. Phillies get two in the inning. They cut it, the deficit to 10-2 as we go to the ninth.
Your attention, please.
If Jonathan Papelbon will come in, this is just a mop-up role. Or is Jonathan shoot? Shoot into the game, batting. He fouls it, no balls and one strike. Foul. Struck him out. Gonna bring up Chris Tillman, who's 0-3. Tillman still in the game. Surprising. A ball and no strikes. Ball and one strike. loop. And Jordan makes the catch. It's two out. It's Steve Pierce.
Right fielder.
He led the game off with a home run and got this Orioles started here. It's put up four in the first. This one's hammered to left. This might be a second home run, and it is. Steve Pierce has gone yard twice. Once in the first, now once here in the ninth. It is 11-2 Baltimore. Steve Pierce, bam, right down the heart of the plate. That was a no doubt about it. Second home run tonight for Pierce.
Shortstop, J.J. Hardy.
Is J.J. Hardy. And Hardy hits this one. And this one will go foul. One strike. Another foul is one ball and two strikes now.
That's a ball.
2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Center field, Ben Rivera puts it away. Steve Pierce homers his second one of the night. We go to the bottom of the night. It's Adrian Beltre. Hunter is in the game for the Orioles. Beltre takes a strike. No balls and one strike. Beltre skies this one to right field, and Pierce makes the catch. Here's one down the bottom of the ninth. It's Salvador Perez. One strike to Perez. One and two. Two balls and two strikes. Broke his bat and it's fouled. Foul, still two balls and two strikes.
That missed. That's a ball.
Full count, Darren Ruff waits on deck. Ball four, walked him. Bring up Darren Ruff, who's 0 for 3. Ethan Martin's up in the bullpen. Phillies have run out of pitchers. And Ruff fouls it. No balls and one strike. Two balls and one strike. That over is 2-2.
Get that running at second base.
Hit foul. Another foul.
Get that runner to second base now. Come on.
Go. No, full count. Well, this is a double play ball. End the game. Orioles beat the Phillies by the score of 11-2. Chris Tillman throwing over 120 pitches picks up the win, and the Orioles dominate the Phillies through the onset. Steve Pierce with two home runs in the game. For the Orioles, 11 runs, 12 hits, one error. The Phillies, two runs, five hits, and no errors. Loser Cliff Lee, he's 4-6. The winner is Chris Tillman, he is 7-4. The player of the game is Steve Pierce, two hits, two home runs. He is the player of the game. The final score is the Orioles 11, the Phillies 2. We talk to you tomorrow from Citizens Bank Park on the Video Game Network.